welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. In this video, I am gonna be sharing 5 different tips on how to live with a pet when you are allergic. So I am someone who suffers from allergies. I am allergic to all sorts of things, including animals, unfortunately. So I am allergic to both cats and dogs to some degree. I developed my allergies in my teenage years, and they have fluctuated in the severity ever since. However, despite being allergic to animals, I love them, and I did not want that to stop me from having a pet. So I currently own a cat. I do not currently have any dogs, but I do hope to be able to get a dog within the next few years. And my tips that I'm sharing here are gonna be able to apply to both cat owners and dog owners, or if you own both, which is the best of both worlds. So some of the stuff I'm gonna be sharing is kind of common sense stuff, but it is also going to tie in with specific products or routines that really, really helped me manage my symptoms. And of course, I think most people who suffer from allergies know this, but it is not the fur you're allergic to. It is the dander, the proteins that their skin produces that you're allergic to. So when it comes to cats, whether you have a short hair or a long hair cat is not going to make a difference to your allergies. When I first adopted my new cat, my allergies were pretty bad for the first couple months. Now, my allergies don't tend to be super severe like some people's are. Sometimes they can be, but for the most part, it's nothing like having an asthma attack. Like usually it's just like itchy, watery eyes, itchy throat, sneezing. That's typically what I get. My throat doesn't typically feel like it's gonna close up and hives, but sometimes that can happen. So when I first brought home my new cat, I was scouring the internet for different tips, advice, anything that I could apply that I haven't already thought of. I came across a lot of unrealistic advice, which was like, get rid of all your carpets. Don't have upholstered furniture. Like, okay, let me just rip out all my carpets right now and sit on lawn chairs instead of a couch. Like, that's not realistic. So hopefully my tips here will be able to either help you manage your symptoms if you already have a pet, or help you reassure your decision in choosing a pet if you have allergies but you really want to get an animal. Tip number one, get yourself an air purifier. That was one of the first purchases I made when I brought my current cat home. So the one I ended up getting was $160, so it was an investment, but for me it was worth it. There are some more cost-effective ones on the market, but this is one of the highest rated ones on Amazon. It's 4.5 stars with almost 3,000 reviews, and it has a HEPA filter. That is, I think, one of the most important things. If you're shopping for an air purifier, make sure it has a HEPA filter. And if you don't know what that means, it just means it's like a high efficiency filter that really traps in the tiny, tiny, tiny particles, so they're not being filtered through and then just pushed back out in the air for you to like breathe in. It's like they're really, really trapping those. So if you are in the market for trying out an air purifier, I highly suggest making sure it has a HEPA filter, because that is going to be key in making sure those particles are sucked in and not spit back out in the air. So with my air purifier, I just have it set up in my living room. I don't constantly run it, but whenever I feel like the air is just starting to get like stale, or I do get a little stuffy and feel a little symptom flare up, I'll start to run it. It's got some different settings, and it has a sensor to tell you when you need to clean the filter. I'm very happy with it. I've had no problems with it thus far. Tip number two is to keep your animal out of your bedroom. This can suck, kind of, because I know everybody likes to like cuddle with their pets in bed, myself included, but the first few months that I had my cat, I kept him out of my bedroom to make sure that I had a safe zone, so to say, for me to go to if my allergies were flaring up, and to just make sure I was gonna get a good night's sleep and wasn't gonna be kept awake from my allergies at night, sneezing with itchy eyes and all that nonsense. So it, like I said, it can be kind of an unfortunate situation, but if you need to give yourself that space for your symptoms to kind of chill out, I think it's really important to keep your bedroom off limits to the animal. Also, we have 2 guest rooms in my house, and we do not let the cat into the guest rooms at all, because when we have visitors who are allergic to animals as well. So I have family and friends who are allergic to cats, so I am trying to make sure I do that service by keeping the animal out of there, so when those people come and visit, they're not gonna have those symptoms flared up. Tip number three is to take care of your animal's fur, specifically with cats. Brush them, invest in a furminator. I have a furminator brush and I try to give my cat a good brush every week or so. And of course, when you brush them, that is going to flare up your symptoms. If you have somebody else in your house who's not allergic, try to get them to do it for you. But that is going to help manage those proteins and the dander in their skin. And if you take one thing from this video that you should give a try if you're allergic to animals, it is a product called Allerpet. I found this on Amazon and it is a liquid formula. I don't have the original bottle anymore. I poured it into a spray bottle, but it is a specially formulated product meant for animals to reduce the amount of proteins that come off their skin. Like I said, I poured it in a spray bottle because it's easier to kind of spray it on the fur and then wipe it in with like a microfiber cloth or an old towel. I'm not gonna lie, my cat definitely doesn't like this and it is kind of a two-person job, but I noticed an almost immediate relief in my symptoms. It was like the next day and I could tell my symptoms were like chilling out. So I highly recommend giving this a try. I try to keep up with spraying my cat down about once a week. Since my allergies have really mellowed out, I don't always do that, but if I do feel like a flare up, I'll make sure I spray him down with this stuff. So like I said, if you take anything from this video, it's to give this product a try because it can really, really help your symptoms. They formulate this spray for both cats and dogs, so it works on either or. And I also suggest getting some grooming wipes. They're basically like baby wipes for animals and you wipe down their fur. It really just helps keep everything clean, getting rid of those allergens off their skin. So taking care of your animal's fur can really help you manage your symptoms with allergies. Tip number four is to clean more frequently, which is kind of common sense, but more specifically, get yourself a vacuum with a HEPA filter. Most vacuums these days, I do believe, are HEPA vacuums. I could be wrong, but if you're not using a HEPA filter vacuum, I can almost guarantee that's contributing to your allergies being completely terrible. Because like I said, with those HEPA filters, they keep those allergen particles from getting spit back out into the air and just rotating and recirculating, so you just keep breathing the same stuff. So when your vacuum is sucking in that air and junk from your carpet and floor and whatever, it's not gonna spit that air back out. That filter is so fine that it is catching all of those particles. So I have the Dyson Animal Ball, I think that's what it's called, the version 2. This is not a cheap vacuum, but it is the best vacuum I have ever used in my entire life. We bought a refurbished one about 6 or so years ago. It was the version 1, and we just upgraded to the version 2, and I would buy it again in an instant. This vacuum is just the best of the best. It sucks up everything. I think it claims to be the vacuum with the most suction available on the entire vacuum market. So, it's heavy duty. A more affordable option, as opposed to the Dyson, is the Shark Animal Vacuum. I had this vacuum quite a few years ago. I don't think it's as good as the Dyson, but it is a good alternative, and it also is a HEPA filter vacuum. And I think I had that vacuum for 7 or 8 years before it kind of took a dump and I had to get rid of it. So it lasted quite a while. Outside of getting yourself a HEPA filter vacuum, you're going to want to really just take care of your upholstery furniture. Use that attachment on your vacuum to really get your upholstery. At least once a week, I am vacuuming my furniture with that attachment to make sure I'm cleaning it really well. And now that the cat sleeps in my bedroom, I'm washing my sheets more frequently. I am washing my cat's bed more frequently. So you're just gonna want to maintain a cleaning routine that's pretty consistent and thorough. This might be difficult for some people, but it's worth it. It's worth it to have a pet. Also, consider getting your air ducts clean, and that's not just for pet allergies, that's for your allergies in general. Getting your air ducts clean in your house can make a huge difference. I think it's suggested to do it at least once a year. I have not done it yet in my current house, but it is on my list of things to do. That can really, really help with limiting the amount of allergens that are just like being pulled through and rotated through your air. And my fifth and final tip is to be patient and give it time. So everybody is different. I'm not a doctor. I don't know what everybody's allergy symptoms are, but for me, time really helped calm my allergies down. When you have an allergic reaction to something, it's because your body thinks it's in danger. It overproduces that histamine, and that is what gives you your allergy symptoms. After you are constantly exposed to the same animal, and I mean like a single animal that has, you know, those specific DNA proteins in its skin, your body is going to realize that it's not in danger and it's gonna calm down. So like I said, the first few months living with my current cat were a little rough. My allergies were pretty bad. Like I said, my symptoms aren't always that terrible, but I had a couple days where they were a little rough. My throat was closing up, I had hives, but now that time has passed, it's been, what, 6 months, maybe more? I have very few problems with allergies. It's very rare, if any. And that's just because my body has adjusted. And I think that's what's going to happen for most people as well. Not always, like I said, I'm not a doctor, I don't know everything, but from what I've read, what I've heard from other people, and my own experience, I can say that time and patience with your body is going to help your symptoms adjust to being around that specific animal. I'm sure there's gonna be some people who are watching this who are like, I can't believe people would put up with all those reactions and problems just to have a stupid animal. And if that's your feelings on the situation, then you have either never had a pet or never had a true loving connection with your pet. Pets are our babies, they're our family, and they bring so much joy to our lives. I did not want to live a life that I had to miss out on having a connection with an animal just because of my allergies. So I hope these tips can help you. And because it's part of the subject, I'm gonna give my last little plug here. If you are considering getting a pet, cat or dog, please, please, please consider adoption. There are so many animals out there who need homes, especially with cats. The shelter that I adopted my cat Abaddon from was completely at max capacity for cats. So please, please, please go check out your local shelters and make sure you spay and neuter your animals. All right, guys, if this was helpful for you in any way, please give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. If you like lifestyle kind of videos like this, I typically make videos about organization, home decor, DIY projects, crafting, cleaning, all sorts of stuff like that. Thanks again, guys, and I'll see you in my next video.
Oh, look at how good they're all being. You guys, oh.